Have you heard of window functions? I hadn't. Learn in this episode how powerful window functions can be, especially when it relates to operational analytics. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Silvano, a program manager on the Azure SQL team. Thanks for joining us again, Silvano.
Yeah, thanks a lot for having me, Anna.
You're becoming a regular, and we're really excited about it. Today, we're going to be continuing our discussion on operational analytics, specifically related to Azure SQL and SQL Server and some of the capabilities that you have at your disposal to make these things go faster and run more efficiently. And, you know, today I just wanted to start by asking you, Silvano, you know, in this landscape when we're doing operational analytics, what are some of the complicated aggregations or functions or things you might be doing in real time? And what are some complexities that might come up?
Yeah, we mentioned actually a lot during these videos about real-time operational analytics. And I think it's really important to start drilling down into kind of what kind of analytics we are actually going to run. So I prepared a couple of slides here. And in general, when we are dealing with this kind of transactional entities, you can think about kind of inventories, sales, warehouses, and so on. You want to typically extract a bunch of detailed rows, right? So about these transactions, but you need also to kind of aggregate some of these dimensions, metrics, and such that makes sense, right? Think about, for example, kind of running totals across kind of a given kind of inventory item, moving averages if we are analyzing kind of sales in real time, comparison like week over week, month over month, kind of statistical analysis. We know that there are tools we can think about like Power BI and DAX language that have kind of specific capabilities in this space. But those are typically intended for, again, those like offline type of analysis on top of our data warehouse structure. What we are talking about here, as we were saying, is, hey, let's do this real time on top of our transactional data. And a lot of these capabilities are actually already implemented in SQL Server and Azure SQL through what is called window functions. If you want to know everything about this very powerful capability, I recommend you this book by my friend Itzik Ben-Gan. This is T-SQL Window Functions from Microsoft Press, and it's fantastic to learn all about this particular one. But let's take a look at the kind of common scenario we're talking about, right? So we have a bunch of sales data, sales transactions, and those transactions are, for example, showing us for a given kind of stock item in our inventory, what are the orders that have been processed over the last X minutes, what is the quantity of a single order, but we also want to know kind of the aggregated total sold, right? So we know at the end of this time period how many items we have been selling about that. And we may want to know, for example, things like, hey, what is the percentage of that particular line item on top of the entire order, or, for example, on top of a given level of aggregation. Okay, so let's take a look at a very common scenario where we see we have like transactional data items here. We are capturing all sales data for a specific stock item that we have in our warehouse, and we see that each new order is basically bringing a quantity of items that we have been selling, and we want to calculate, for example, a running total of how many of them we've been selling on top of a given time period, for example. And we want to know on that the same data result set, by the way, how much a given row here is impacting on top of the total kind of sales for that item in percentage, right? So we can execute this kind of queries. There are a lot of real real world situations where we want to interrogate our sales systems system in real time. Okay, so how we have been solving this problem in the past before again having this tools like window functions, right? So what we were doing here, we were typically creating more complex queries. In this case, I'm using a common table expression here to define my result set, my initial details in the result set. And then what I'm doing here, I'm creating subqueries where I'm summing up all the quantities in the rows that are basically preceding the current one, right? So what I'm doing here, sum on top of all the line items that are smaller or equal to the current one in my outer query. Sorry. So this is good. This is actually working. The problem is we are typically increasing performance the more our data set is growing, right? The more our time interval is growing, performance are basically degrading in very significantly. And actually, they are growing exponentially because what the query plan basically will become is a very complex one where this kind of recursion that we have is basically bringing performance to tens or hundreds of seconds in terms of execution time. What we can do here instead with the new school, so with the this window functions, is we can use this new kind of keyword called over, and basically we can define in our result set how we want to basically calculate this particular aggregation function here. And in this case, we want to basically aggregate on top of our stock item ID, as we see, order by, in this case, order ID. And we want this sum operation here to get executed on all the rows that are preceding the current one, right? Rows unbounded preceding means exactly what I'm saying, right? So this is one way of actually executing, defining this kind of boundaries for this particular aggregation function. The second line here is slightly different. We are still doing this over, but in this case, we are just calculating the essentially the weight of the single row on top of the entire kind of result set for this particular frame that we created here by filtering our rows. So the result here is, as you can see, very, very performant. Actually, the query that was taking 100 seconds before is actually taking 200 milliseconds. And this is because window functions are working very well in conjunction with our clustered column stores, and they are also capable of switching to the batch execution mode. Batch execution mode is, as we were discussing, is the ability to basically execute, in this case, an aggregation function on top of multiple rows. So it's not a row-based operation, but is basically vectoring across a bunch of rows this calculation. So let's take a look at some quick demo here. So this is exactly the old style query that I was discussing previously, right? So we are running on top of the same 500 million table that I was showing you in previous videos, right? We are just looking at one single kind of stock item here, and we are aggregating, we are calculating those running totals on a 15 minutes time windows, right? And by the way, just remember, we still have our OLTP workload in the background, which is inserting thousands of rows per second in this particular table, right? So if we run this one, rows are starting to flow immediately, but as we can see, the query is actually taking, is not over yet. So we are still aggregating rows. And we will see that this is probably going to take again quite some time in order to get executed, right? Let's give it a few seconds more. Or actually, let's skip this. We will go to this later on. And let's take a look instead how we can solve the same problem by executing our window function-based query, right? So this is exactly what I was showing previously, right? Running on top of the same exact data set, and boom, right? So we are executing in around 100 millisecond the same query that here still has to complete, right? And you know, the reason is exactly what I was mentioning previously, right? Unfortunately, this subquery-based approach is basically going to be influenced exponentially by the amount of data we have in that result set to calculate, while, you know, we are basically executing at linear pace on the window function side, okay? So you can see the difference is pretty significant.
Wow. Silvano, you definitely have my attention. I haven't worked with window functions a lot, but two things that, you know, are very obvious that stand out here is one, with window functions, you had to write way less T-SQL. It seems like there's a lot of built-in verbiage that you can use to accomplish with way less code. And two, of course, it runs so much faster. Now, when I start to implement these window functions, it seems like there's some built-in words and capabilities that I should be aware of. Are there like main things or main insights on how to kind of set these up?
Yeah, absolutely. So the two main parts of this this syntax is first of all kind of your preferred aggregation functions that you effectively have to run on top of these windows, where windows are effectively how you are slicing and dicing your result set. So this over keyword here is doing, you know, most of the magic, and is basically telling us how we want to operate on top of the result set that we are actually defining with our kind of very classic predicate here, right? So first of all, you know, this is giving us the window, the main window where we are going to operate. And then the over keyword here is telling us how we want to slice. In this case, we want to slice by this stock item ID. And then we are basically telling with some few keywords how we are going to execute that sum function that we have seen at the beginning of the line here, how we are basically going to operate on top of the remaining rows, right? So in this case, what we are doing, we are applying to all our preceding rows to the one that we are actually executing in this particular moment, right? So this is the key of the entire feature here. So in terms of, you know, the window functions available are typically categorized between kind of ranking functions. So whenever we want to kind of generate sequential sequences, kind of row numbers, for example, to kind of generate a new sequential number for each row, rank the data, you know, between different kind of groups, with gaps or without gaps. We have kind of standard aggregation functions here, you know, the sum, average, count, and so on, but also kind of statistical deviations, statistical variance, and such, plus a bunch of other kind of analytics functions, how they call it. So the ability, for example, to go back one row and calculate, for example, the result or the difference between the current row and the previous row, and a bunch of other very interesting functions that we can use to create powerful analytical queries on top of our real-time data.
Wow, this is really cool, Silvano. Again, this is something very new to me. And so to realize that we have all this kind of built-in functionality that's going to make our lives easier, not just from writing the T-SQL, but also getting performance out of our data. This is pretty cool. I'm really excited about Windows functions. You know, if you had one piece of advice that you would share with folks as they get started with this and implementing this or trying to find where this fits, what piece of advice would you give?
Yeah, just go ahead and learn about this type of capabilities. The more you can push kind of your computation requirements into the database and closer to the where the data resides, this will give you a lot of efficiency in the way you are implementing your solutions. You know, you could calculate statistical and analytical functions on your application, but why do that, right? We have a powerful relational system on the back that is fully capable of executing these particular features and functions, and actually do it very efficiently because this is where the data resides, right? So I will definitely recommend you to take a look at books like the one that I mentioned previously and learn about window functions, because this will give you a boost in terms of performance in your analytical solutions.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for joining us on this little mini series about operational analytics. I've learned a lot, and I'm sure our viewers have as well. And to our viewers, if you like this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think about operational analytics with Azure SQL and SQL Server. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.